Welcome to Wax Off. My name is Robina Reyesat and I'm a hearing aid audiologist. I'll be talking through our earwax removal videos, so let's see some wax. This patient, let's call her Linus Hightower. Linus has particularly small bendy ear canals, and because of this the wax builds up quite quickly. She's a super bubbly patient who is always very upbeat, and I actually love spending time with her during her appointment. I'm starting off on the right side, and as you can see I've oiled and I'm using a standard probe tip. The standard size Zollner is being used here because I need the larger suction surface area to get this blockage out, and my plan is always to get the wax out in one go. As you can see, the wax had other ideas and decided to break off at the surface while I'm gathering all of the wax in one area. Here is what's left of the wax. It extends quite deep into the ear canal, and from this angle it's clear the ear canal gets quite bendy and windy towards the deeper areas. The Zollner is inserted back in, and this time it attaches nicely and comes away revealing the eardrum. A sizable blockage, and here's one view followed by the other side. Here comes the tidying up part. Sometimes these areas, which look like residue of wax at the entrance of the ear canal, can actually be comprised of a thin layer of keratin covered by wax residue. So here I'm suctioning very gently to see if there are any keratin layers with that residue on top, in which case they will come away very cleanly and very nicely. I've tried two areas and neither of them come off, so here I'm going to the roof of the ear canal, although it's showing on the left of the screen for you because of the way I'm holding the endoscope. And there is some light keratin here which comes off, but I'm going to switch to a smaller sized fine tip here. The fine tip does grab hold of it better, but it's still not wanting to come off. It's going into the tube, but then it's still attached to the ear canal skin. Final attempt to remove as many of the entrance residues and pieces of keratin here. And here is one of those layers of keratin I was speaking about a few moments ago that come off cleanly at the entrance with residue on top. Some has come away and lifted up, but clearly isn't ready to come off as well. And here is a final shot of the eardrum. The blockage has been removed, the eardrum is intact, a little thicker looking skin making up the eardrum than I would have liked to have seen, and slightly more opaque as well than I would usually expect. The eardrum is also an oval shape as opposed to the lovely round shape that you see on some of my other patient videos. But this is just a variation of a normal looking eardrum. Now over to the left side. There has been some oil again used in the ear canal, but it hasn't travelled as far down as I would have liked it to. When I enter with the endoscope, it tries to smudge the end of the endoscope. Nice try, olive oil, but I quickly move it out of the way and it saves the image blurring. But that thin layer of wax I'm trying to reach doesn't want to come off. Back in and very gently at the top of the screen, I'm pulling away at the sticky wax at the roof, and we have a piece of keratin and wax extracted here. It's quite a long piece of keratin. As the Zolna moves back in, you can see I'm moving away the soft vellus hairs at the entrance, and there is a lot of glare back from the endoscope light. But when I get in, I manage to get hold of some of the shedded keratin still stuck on the ear canal wall. And like some of the other pieces during this video, it just doesn't want to come off yet. Some pink skin is being revealed underneath here, so I'm being very careful as I don't want to pull off anything that may make the ear canal sore. Here I'm getting the sticky keratin layer and wax to merge on one side. So I'm folding it on itself and then to the left, followed by moving it from right to left. And you can see just how deceptive the original amount of wax looked in the original shot, where it simply looked like peripheral residue. But now you can see just how much there is there. The same blanketing technique, and here I've made some progress. The keratin is finally beginning to come off, and I have another piece of wax and keratin. Quite dry and keratinous, which is why it was so hard to get off. Final gliding of the probe over the keratin and wax at the entrance. And some comes away. Here's a final shot of the eardrum on the left side. You can see this eardrum looks very different from Lioness's right eardrum. It has a beautiful cone of light reflection, and the colour is that beautiful mother of pearl colour that we expect. And here you can see there is still some keratin remaining at the entrance, which is okay to leave there. Please do keep the questions coming, keep subscribing, hit that notification bell. We're trying to get to 2,000 subscribers now, and we can only do that with your help. So please keep coming back every week and subscribe to my channel. Peace out, and I will see you in the next one.